today, and that's entirely down to the fact that you've given so much support for this. Without that support, we wouldn't be able to step outside the church ways in such a big and bold way that really impacts the community, and we thank you for that. That's really great. Thank you so much.
My name's Ken Fox, and I'm the proprietor of the last remaining wall of death still operating and touring Great Britain. I'm here once again at the Dorset Steam Fair. I've been coming here 21 years, and Roger's always been on hand whenever we need any assistance with anything. And Roger was there to bless my wedding inside the wall 10 years ago this year.
Yeah.
And we're still going very strong, and Roger always pops down every year to make sure we're still happily married. And Roger does a good job for the church.
Hi there, my name's Roger Redding. I'm chaplain to the Great Dorset Steam Fair. Thank you very much for your contribution to help us in the church tent here. We've reached over 1,000 people this week, and we hope that in the future we will be able to again be able to do this to reach out to the community with the gospel of Christ. Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Tony. Welcome to Weymouth. Place that during the day has lots of tourists, shoppers and office workers walking around in normally glorious sunshine. Terrific place to be. But night time the whole scene changes, and you get the pubbers and the clubbers just as we got in the background here.
Yesterday was a carnival.
Yeah.
It was actually quite frightening. A lot of arrestings and that kind of business going on.
Yeah.
Just an hour ago I saw somebody get arrested.
Yeah? What were they arrested for?
For indecent exposure and theft.
Really?
Yeah. It is a different scene from what I'm used to.
So, Weymouth at night, lots of vulnerable people are around, pretty intimidating environment at times. And what we're looking to do is to work alongside the police and the local community to be out here on the streets and working with those people who are vulnerable. People who are just laid out on pavement because they've drunk too much, trying to help them to get home okay. And that's really what we look to the Aldhelm Fund to try and help us with the funding for that whole initiative. It's about taking the church to the streets and helping people, just in the way that Christ did.
Come to the bike project every Monday, Tuesday. It's great fun. Nothing about it is unfun, and it's a laugh.
And built this beastie bike.
And we built this one.
Hello, I'm Peter Homden, community evangelist and development worker at the Church of the Good Shepherd, Rossmore. We're here at the moment at the Rossmore Bike Project. It's a project where we have approximately 8 to 20 young people coming quite regularly, where we build bikes, we give parts away, we endeavour to build relationships with the young people in the community, keeping them off the streets, but also talking to them about life issues and endeavouring to do some mentoring work with them. And it's thanks to St Albans Trust that we're able to do this work, so thank you.
Peter's a great man, bike project's fun, and us boys, we do our stuff.
Learned like how to fix buckles on wheels, how to fix cranks, derailleurs, and front gears. So help me try and get a job at bike mechanics as well. Thanks for the money for the bike mechanic maintenance. Very happy. See ya.
We meet once a week, and on a Thursday evening between 5 o'clock and 6:45, and we have about 30 children who are aged between 5 and 11 now, and pretty well everyone comes every week, don't they? Yeah. And we have a really good time. We play games to begin with, and then we usually have an introduction for about 10 minutes when we welcome the children and we tell them what the theme for the week is. Then there's some sort of an activity on that theme. Break for refreshments, and then very often a craft activity after that, and then we sort of finish off with a prayer.
It's fun every Thursday because you think, oh, this has been a rubbish day at school, so you just come and...
Yeah, because in my...
like doing French.
Because I have French.
Yeah, we have French
on Thursday.
It's pretty boring.
And yeah,
and it bores me to death.
Yeah, and then you think,
oh, well, yes, Crusaders on. Crusaders after school.
So we think, let's go.
Yeah. So we kind of rush home. I kind of rush home with my friend Carly there, who walks home with me. And we kind of like, we run home, get changed, and then Carly comes to meet me at 5 to 5, and like, we all walk kind down. Of come here.
Yeah.
Have fun.
Well, this is just my second time at Crusaders. Now, I've approached it with some trepidation, I must confess, but it's been really great. And it's good to see the youngsters together and enjoying themselves. And all I can really say is I've enjoyed it so far. So keep on helping us to run this club. It's been a real worthwhile effort, hasn't it?
The great thing about the Aldhelm Mission Fund was that it enabled us to set up Millbourne Praise so that we could do church outside of the church building. So we got, we've been able to buy the projector and DVD players and all the equipment that goes with it, but also the things that mean that we can be creative. Whether it's craft things for children or whether it's songs to sing, music to show, videos. So we tried to do something a little bit different every time, and because of the mission money we got, we've been able to do that.
Hi, I'm Michelle and welcome to Playzone. And I just want to say thank you to you at St Aldhelm's, because if it wasn't for you, I couldn't be funded to do this each week. And this is a real case of the church going out into the community. We are reaching out here to parents, and it's just so great. And it's not just a parent and toddler group. We are giving them support. We link with the children's centre. They often come in, and there's health visitors that come and visit, and it's just a great opportunity for mums to come and meet. So I just want to say thank you and just hope that it continues.
How many more bites can you take? One?
Yeah.
Two? Nine. Go on then.
Thank you.
One thing the project has enabled me to do is work with all age groups. On Friday mornings we have Chatterbox, which is a baby clinic, and it also encourages parents to stay and chat. Hello Katie, that is lovely. And that feeds into Playzone, which enables the parents to meet at Chatterbox and come here as well. And then that feeds on into the preschool, and it makes such a difference with the children that come that have been here. They just settle straight away, and parents know each other, and it's really great. And we come in and do assemblies in preschool, and also I'm going to start a lunchtime club at the local school. So it is feeding all different age groups. It's not just this age group. I'm dealing with up to 7 to 11 year olds as well, regularly each week, and we do assemblies in the schools as well, so it really is, but we're going out into the community.
Thanks for supporting us.
Thanks for supporting us.
Thanks for supporting us.